how is a classroom teacher supposed to teach coding when maybe they don't really know how to code? And when you think about it, one of the key tenets of this whole idea behind computer science and coding is not so much about learning the specifics of a single program or a single app, but about developing this literacy and this fluency around the ideas of what allows a computer to do the tasks that it's capable to do. And so one activity that you might think about doing is just introducing this idea of coding as a language. And to do that, we can use Book Creator. So one activity to consider would be to use Book Creator and to really focus on this idea of language. So to get started, I'm just going to open up Book Creator and I'll start a new book, and you could pick any size you want. The trick though is make sure that all the students choose the exact same size. So this time around, we're all gonna choose a square book, and we'll tell all the students in the class to choose a square book, and this is just a little setup. The other piece of setup is to come into your I button, and then where it says page color, you want graph paper. So we're gonna get a grid on here. Now the purpose of this activity is to introduce this idea of language and to explain that computers and different apps and different devices all work on similar types of language. And when we're working with this particular activity, we're going to teach a number of commands to our students. And our ultimate objective is going to be to program our partner to draw a picture of a house. So a couple of things we'll use as we build our coding language. So the first one is we'll teach our students that we can say add shape. So that would be our first step. And then we could pick. So let's say we say add shape square. So I'll choose a square, and that puts it on. So that's our first coding line of code, add shape square. And then what we could do is change the color. So we could say add shape square I color gray. Now I've done my second piece of code. The other thing that I can start to teach my students, and this also has some mathematic implications, is I could teach the idea of an XY coordinate or an XY plane. When I move a shape in Book Creator, see how it gives me the XYs? So my Ys are moving up and down, and then my Xs. So I might say to my students, okay, X coordinate 188, Y coordinate 475. And I believe it's pulling off of sort of that middle piece. With younger students, what I could do is have them actually count the squares on the bottom. So, and they might even want to come in and get a pen. Or sorry, so we'll go over here, we'll get a pen, and maybe we'll even be able to say like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 9 squares, you know, from the bottom, 9 squares over. So we could use that as part of our language as well. So we've basically already said to our students, they've learned the idea of add, they've learned how to change the color, they've learned XY coordinates. We'll do another one. Let's say, okay, so add shape triangle, and I'm gonna put a roof on this house. And so again, I might want to count the squares if I was a younger student, or give an XY coordinate. So now I'm gonna move this down and I'd say X188, Y275. And maybe I want to change it this time. I want a sort of a squatty roof. So I would say height, let's go 121. And as I work through this activity, ultimately I'm focused on teaching this language, and I'm basically going to program my partner to do a house. So now let's say that we're actually going to play this game. And the way it would work is the first person, so say I'm partnered up with my, you know, imaginary friend out here in cyberspace, I would tell them to add the first shape. They would do it, but then they would add the second shape. So partner two might have done the triangle and tell me to do the triangle. And then I might add a shape, and we go back and forth and back and forth until we think we've got a house. And this can get fairly complicated. Let's say we want a chimney, and we might say add shape square. And then I might change the color. So I'll say I color red. And now I need to make it, we'll change this again, and we might say width is, you know, 50. And let's make this shorter. We'll say height is 105. And then we could move it over X 438, Y 371. And I could even layer it, or maybe I want to move it over a little bit more. But we could talk about sending things forwards and backwards. I guess it would have been more obvious if it was a different color. Let's make a black chimney. And then we could say, you know, move back. And now we start layering things. But we could get pretty sophisticated in how we design the house. And then in the end, ask our students, how many different commands did they come up with? And they could even keep a sheet of paper or use a different app and write out all the commands that they used. And then see if someone else could even replicate their house again. So you could use this over and over again without having to know how to use a particular coding app. You can start to introduce the idea of coding, teaching students with different language, all just using the Book Creator app.